Hi, I'm Adria Ray, and you're listening to The Kickback Show.
Fuck with me and get some money, and get some money. Ay, fuck with me and get some money, and get some money. Yeah, fuck with me and get some money. Ay, yeah.
And we're back, Hollywood, California. It's the Kickback Show at Dash Radio. First of all, we got you guys in the building, so you know it's a good day out here, Sunday in Hollywood. But the world's falling apart, meanwhile, everywhere else.
Yes, it is.
I feel like LA's kind of just still holding it down. You guys are chiefing big right now, just blowing this pen back to back.
Yes, I know.
She's over here raising her hand.
It's loud in here.
Can I?
You really got something to say.
You can raise my hand. Go ahead. Danny, you're on the air.
Okay. I don't know if you're done though with what you were saying.
So. No, go ahead.
I feel like a dick. Are you sure?
I'm 100% waiting on you.
Right now. Okay.
So. All right. And
so
wait. Okay, go.
Okay. All right. You sure?
Oh, we're good.
We're good. Okay. So I just was wanting to put out there before like I forget about this.
Okay.
Is me and a couple other people are trying to get together to like do fundraising for Texas and Florida.
Okay.
And so
that's dope.
We're thinking, I even contacted like KTLA, and if I can pitch it correctly to them, like, you know, they're just gonna like put it on TV and everything. So like we just kind of make it a big thing. And so we're putting all these ideas together, but basically like when it is done, like I'll just share my social media so you guys
can follow. And we'll definitely support that as well.
Whoever like can come and donate, and like, you know, like we're gonna make it like fun.
Yeah, because Florida's being hit as we speak right now pretty hard too.
So
and you know, especially in California, like you get that mix of like everyone's from everywhere.
Yeah.
So
right.
I feel like everyone here is like kind of being affected by it somehow, one way or another.
Yeah.
And I know a lot of people like want to help out is a thing. And like some people don't know some like how to. So, you know, this might be.
Now we're going to show them the way, right?
Yeah.
Show them the way.
Dope though. I respect that. Mm-hmm. That, you know, that you're supporting, because there's a lot going on. It's like everybody, because especially out here in LA, it's everything's just la-di-da-di. You don't even see what's half the time what's going on.
Yeah,
half the time I'm on Twitter reading the news like, holy shit, it's really going down out there. But
and everybody's just, you know, sitting there eating their dinner. Like,
I didn't even know there was a fire.
Pasty butter.
20 miles
north
of I didn't realize there was a fire in Burbank the other day.
Oh, that shit was wild. No, actually, I was running up Runyon's. You know Runyon, right? I get to the top of Runyon.
Yes.
No, the whole back of the valley was on fire.
Dude, my friend on Facebook put like a list of like 10 places right now in the world
that are just on fire.
Oh, no shit. And then Portland was just burning down too. It's like, that's what I'm talking about. It's crazy.
Guys,
it's like, this has got to be written somewhere. Someone's like, yep, I told you, the Mayans were right.
I feel like there's
something.
So much bad shit going on that I'm losing track of all the bad shit that's
right?
going on.
I just don't want to know. Anymore.
But what's good? What's,
you
know,
what's been good?
What's good? What's
what
really
is
good?
We're blessed. We're all here.
Definitely.
Yeah,
you know?
California.
The weather's nice. It finally cooled down. It was hotter than shit like a week ago. I was dying. Yeah. During those fires, actually.
Yeah.
I thought the fires were like literally heating up LA.
No, I guarantee it had something to do with it.
Yeah.
Like I was saying, I hit Runyon when I got to the top, and my brother was visiting like a week ago. And I'm like, bro, I go, what the fuck? And I thought, I was like, you know, like sometimes we have crazy sunsets out here.
Yeah.
The whole ridge behind the valley was basically on fire. You could see the flames. I'm like, that's a legit fire. And I looked it up, and it was like the La Tuna fire or something like that. Yeah, exactly. I was like, no way.
Yeah, and it's pretty like rural out there that way too. It's like it's a lot of farms.
It was a lot.
And so
it was a lot.
I'm in Studio City, and even on my back balcony, I have like a little like daybed thing, and it was covered in ash from the fire.
Oh,
like,
damn! Yeah,
in the air.
That stuff can't be good. We already got smog. We don't need to be breathing that stuff too.
Yeah, and I was like, I just got this. I'm gonna wash it.
Damn
taking it. A daybed cover off.
Back to the laundry mat.
So there's our first world problems we're dealing with.
I know, right? Well, you know, much love to everybody who's dealing with all the bullshit out down there, but I guess there's a reason why we moved to LA. It's nice out here.
You
guys both from LA?
No.
Okay, where are you from, Adria?
I'm from Michigan originally.
What brought you to LA?
It was cold as shit there.
Okay. Yeah, Michigan gets really cold, right?
Yeah, it was like waking up at 6 a.m. to like dig your car out of the snow and like It was just a pain in the ass.
Did you already know that you're like, I'm moving to LA, that's my spot, I'm
well,
going?
Well, my parents fucked up by bringing me here when I was like 14. And then
they fucked up?
You're yeah, like, because,
you done fucked up.
Because from then on out, I was like, why the fuck do I live here?
Shit.
Yeah, I was just like, do you enjoy torturing me as your child?
Why? Because you just couldn't do anything? Or just because
well,
it was like the
thing,
dopest place you've ever been to? And
that,
you're like, right.
It's totally like a pipe dream for like somebody like me who comes from like a small town, like where you get snowed in, you can't do shit besides like play video games.
Do you snowboard or ski or anything? Or I always wonder because I grew up on the West Coast and we kind of get like all four seasons. I'm from Portland, Oregon, but I moved to California. I've been back and forth for a while.
So
but,
you've been like spoiled by them all, kind of.
Yeah.
All the seasons.
Yeah. I actually love seasons. Mm-hmm. Like when I saw the trees in front of my house dying this last week, I was like, hell yeah, fall's finally here. I'm over the summer. I'm like, I'm ready to start putting some layers on and, you know,
get into it. Get in the hoodie mode.
I went to Starbucks. It was 95 degrees on my Snapchat and it had the little fall is here. The pumpkin spice latte is now
like
available.
95.
I literally put the temperature on it. It was like 95 degrees. I'm like, it doesn't feel like fall, but fall is here technically. Actually, I don't know when the first day of fall is, but you know how that shit goes. And Danny.
Yes.
What about you? Where are you from?
I'm from Nebraska.
Nebraska, two imports.
Yes.
And what brought you to LA?
I just wanted to live the dream, man.
Right?
Yeah.
It's the place to be.
Yeah, I just wanted to be motivated to do something to sit on my ass and just look at fucking nothing.
Yeah, it's a whole lot of nothing.
Yeah, it's a lot of nothing.
Nebraska?
Yeah.
It's funny you say that because actually a long time ago, I don't know where I came up with it, I came up with this character called Nebraska Ned. And I used to do this like country accent. I'm like,
what?
I'm going to pull up the video later. You guys going to crack
funny.
Up laughing.
I definitely want to see Nebraska
Ned. Somehow there was this mask that someone left in the studio a long time ago. And I used to pull it on like Nebraska Ned. And I used to like huck corn and I had donkeys and shit. I'll play the video. It's going to be hilarious when you see it. But
awesome.
Yeah,
but
I don't know if that's what Nebraska's really like. Cause I don't think I've ever been there.
Right.
But I had this like vision in my mind of what Nebraska.
No, it's not like that. It's like, it's very, it reminds me of like Chicago. Like it's very city.
Okay.
Like, I'm from Omaha. So like, I'm not from.
Oh,
Omaha.
That's where Nebraska Ned's from. I swear to God.
He's from Omaha,
Nebraska. I'm going to pull this shit up.
We have to see him now.
This is
so funny.
Like
so anyway,
neighbor.
Go on. I want to hear. What's the difference? What, Omaha. I mean, at what age did you move here?
18.
She was out.
I was like,
you're like,
peace.
Same with you?
Yeah.
I drove.
Yep.
LA. So you've been in LA Hollywood since, huh?
Yep. 2 years now.
Mine's six. Mm-hmm. And I'm not leaving.
And so Danny, you're a fitness model from what I understand.
Yes. Like,
yep. So, get into detail. What's that all about? What's that
like? I just started kind of like really getting into it. Like I've always been into it.
Okay. You work out a lot?
Yes.
Obviously.
Her body is nuts.
You got a six pack?
Well,
not right now.
Oh, you working on that? Oh, you did? What happened?
Well,
took the summer off?
No.
I gotta know what's going on here. Girl, you're a fitness model.
No, so I just did my first figure competition a week and a half ago.
Is that when the girls do like the whole like the muscle thing? And the,
no, but I wasn't like that.
Flex, they pop their booty out real hard. And,
it's not like that one.
Okay, different
it's,
one.
It's like figure, so it's like more sexy. It's lean.
Okay.
It's like more like bikini,
yeah,
I would say.
Sorry,
way more my
bikini.
Style. No, some of those girls are hella muscular. I'm like, I don't know if
I'm it's not like a bodybuilder.
Okay.
But I did it, and it was my first one. And
how'd you place?
I got first.
No way.
Yeah.
Danny, congratulations. That's huge.
Thank you. So.
First place. That's like, you got bragging rights. You got a trophy for that or what?
Yeah, I got medals, but I,
That's you?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was like super fun.
Danny.
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 No, you didn't.
Daniel.
Yeah.
So now, what is that? What's the next phase from there?
So now, in November, I'm going to Nationals. So,
the road
continues. To go pro.
Okay.
Yes, but this one is very more intense because you are just trying to like,
but you took first place in L.A. That's huge. Like, L.A. is like, if you've taken first
Anaheim.
Place in...
It was in Anaheim.
L.A.
That's still L.A.
Anywhere else in the world is considered L.A., you know?
Yeah.
You could have said Orange County. I would have been like, L.A.
Yeah. And, but so I did that to, like, kickstart it because I really want to see how I was going to do it. And I was only 4 weeks out. And I was like, fuck it. I'm just going to do it because my coach is like, you can do it.
You can do it.
Yeah. And so, also, I feel like a lot of us were like joking to you, like, you should just do a fitness competition. Like,
yeah, everyone your
body, why are you like, do you have like a really toned body, anyways, obviously? Like, everybody's encouraging
come
you.
Around us and, yeah. Like, everyone would always comment, like, yeah. Dude, you look insane. Like, your body's nuts right now. Like,
yeah. So I just like, fuck it, I'm going to do this shit. Mm-hmm. So
and then you take first place. That's badass.
Yeah. So then my coach was like, well, fuck, if you took first and did this, like, you might as well just try and do nationals. Cause I was like, I want to do this. I want to go fucking big because I'm just working on my whole like fitness thing, so I'm starting my fitness line and working on that shit.
And what's that called? Like a fitness clothing line?
Yeah,
or?
We're just making the samples right now. I'm not putting a name on it yet. So.
Wow, you're just like, fuck it, I'm going fitness model, I'm going all in.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And so, and then doing just like photo shoots and videos and fitness stuff and social media.
Getting it.
Yeah, just hustling, man.
Hustle. I'm digging the Reebok windbreaker. I was Thank talking you. About that on the break.
I appreciate it.
And we were talking about windbreakers are coming back.
They're coming back.
The
it
colors,
is.
Though, is what it is.
It I've is, too. The red, white, and blue. You can't go wrong with
though.
That.
No.
It's the best. Like, but I'm a little different because like, I like them because I can wear them when I go golfing. So it's like that rain
Those
gear
nice.
Hey,
on
I like
top
that.
Of looking swaggy.
You golf?
I do golf.
Yeah. Often?
She's
or?
Badass, too.
Damn, we got some like multi-talented professionals in the building.
You got skills, man.
Yeah. Clearly. I was unaware.
Got a little bit of skills.
I just thought we had a couple pretty faces walking through the door. I didn't know you guys were so talented. But that's added bonus. I can't go wrong. Yeah. I mean, you got all the gold chains. You got the big Lebowski glasses. I mean, we're doing it big today.
Hey. I told her. I was like, we got a dress to impress. Show out today.
Yeah. And so, Adria, you're in the sex industry, right? From what I understand.
Am.
Is that
I
what
am.
You call it? The sex industry?
I guess you could call it that.
The
there,
sexual
I feel like
industry.
There's a lot of.
That's kind
of
harsh, though.
Is it?
Adult
okay, how about
industry,
the. Ooh, there we go. The adult
like
film
the
industry.
The PC version of saying
I think
it.
Less, I like adult film industry.
Like, if you said it to your mom, she wouldn't be offended.
My mom, nothing really offends my mom at this point. She's so go with the flow, it didn't even matter. She's like, man.
Like,
she's probably going to watch this episode anyway and be like, that was a good show. But so, yeah. So you've been in some films, I'm assuming.
Yeah, a couple hundred.
A couple hundred? Damn, okay. Any big ones? Any reputable ones that are like, oh, that's a big hit? Like, tons of views?
See, it really just depends. Like, I mean, sometimes I'll go on Pornhub and, like, peruse and see, like, what scenes are, like, the top or, like, what's not.
You're like, I'm doing that in my next film for sure.
It really just depends on, like, where the company's streaming it. If
okay.
they're putting it on websites that has, like, a lot of, like, traffic, a lot of streaming.
Pornhub? Is that the biggest one?
Exactly. If they throw it up on Pornhub and a bunch
Most
of
dudes
sites,
jack to Pornhub. I hear that phrase thrown around a lot.
Go-to.
I want to get a Pornhub shirt. I feel like that would get a lot of, like...
Yeah,
maybe, like,
actually,
a dope tee, you know, like Pornhub.
Hey, there's actually a little moment for me to plug.
Okay,
little,
go ahead and
little,
drop it.
Some little pro porn gear that you can get. There's actually shorts that Pornhub is making, and it shows all the countries that porn's banned in.
Oh, wow.
And it's kind of basically like advocating to, like, you know, change that, obviously.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, you're putting them on blast.
Yeah, like, it's porn. Like, come on.
Come
like,
on. Everybody needs love.
Everyone needs to, like, jag off every once in a while.
Right?
Like,
shit happens.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Like, you have a bad breakup or, like, you have
Shit.
A shitty leg.
Log
like,
it on to Pornhub. Here we go.
Exactly.
And rub it out.
We're so, just, like, animals, though. So, like, animals like to...
Mate. No, I definitely mate.
Sex will always sell.
It does. And that's why we have you beautiful ladies here on the Kickbox Show today. So do you have any favorite films you've ever been featured in? Or
favorite? I recently did a showcase with a girl that I wanted to work with for a while.
Okay. And who's that?
And her name is Lana Rhodes. And it actually came out really well. And
nice.
Like, I got
like girl on girl or?
Yeah. Girl on girl, and it was really cool because, like, how they filmed it was just, like, very, like, cinematic and, like, kind
straight
of,
up movie.
Yeah, like, it was, like,
red cameras, all kinds of proper lighting.
It wasn't, like, some just, like, gonzo shit. Like,
so do you actually get intimate with the girl, or is it all, like, you turn on the act, like, when it's time to, okay, let's get it on, all of a sudden it's, like, okay, everything's out
the
window.
Girl. It really depends on the girl, because, like, if the girl...
Like, this one, you were obviously sweating before you came into the show, right?
Yeah, like, I mean...
So, like, damn, I can't wait to fuck this girl. I wonder if the guys ever think that.
Oh, I'm sure. No, for sure.
Like, I've been watching your Pornhub all week, girl. I cannot wait to smash.
I mean, I have a buddy who's in the industry, and he tells me all the time that, like, whenever
when we get the chance,
with the different MILFs and stuff that are in the industry,
yeah,
he's been jerking off to them, you know, since he's
MILFs,
like,
you
yeah,
say?
Like, you know, girls that have been in for a long time, like 10 plus years.
Damn, vets.
And he's coming around, he's 20, and he's like, I used to jerk off to these girls when I was 14.
And now,
now
I'm getting paid
now.
To have sex with them.
Yeah, like, so, I mean,
can't
I'm
be
sure
mad at that.
Everyone has those, like, people that they're like, oh, I can't wait to work with them.
Right, but, right.
Yeah, I mean, it ended up being good, but it depends on the like performer. Some are really like just totally an act, and mm-hmm. some like love that like connection with you. So yeah. Just depends on the person. Like everyone's different. So if I come in and some girl like doesn't like eating vagina and she yeah. ends up having to eat mine, then like, yeah.
Get it, girl.
Sorry, girl. Oh, but like, we're both in it for the team right now. Yeah.
Like, you want that check, right? You better get down there.
Exactly.
That's funny. So, what was your first porn like? Like going into it, were you nervous?
I was terribly nervous. I was 18.
Was it guy
old.
On girl?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I like went like.
Is that considered like an amateur since it was like your first one, or mm-hmm. how's that? Okay, I've always confused like with the terms. There's like hardcore, there's amateur, there's like anal. I mean, obviously we know what anal is, but I'm just saying there's all kinds of different porn categories now.
Of course, I know there's a million different niches. And right. There's balloon porn.
Balloon porn. What in the hell is balloon porn?
It's the funniest one.
Have you ever done balloon porn?
Oh, I have. And
please go into detail. I have to hear about balloon porn.
Balloon porn is a fetish where guys are turned on by girls getting scared from balloons popping.
Okay. So you're just in there popping balloons and having sex at the same time.
You're not even having sex. You're literally just sitting on balloons until they pop, and then you act scared, and that's it.
And some dude's like, oh, God.
Yes. I'm not kidding.
I've heard it all. Balloon porn.
Or I had one guy come up to me at one of the conventions, and he had a bunch of balloons, and he was like, will you blow this up until it pops? And I was like, yeah, sure. And he was like recording me, and like I blew it up until it popped. And of course, it scares you when mm-hmm. it pops because you're not expecting it.
Right.
And afterwards, I was asking him, I was like, what? Like, I don't understand. Like, what was the purpose of this? And he's like, oh, like you've never heard of balloon porn before?
I get off the reaction.
That's so weird.
That's crazy.
Like, that's so crazy. So everyone has like their own.
I learned something
weird
new
thing.
Today. What can I say?
No, I think the weirdest one that I've ever seen is when they have a fucking doll and they act like it's real and take it with them in public.
Oh yes.
Have you ever seen that shit?
No, they bring like a blow up doll and toddler.
No, either a blow up doll or like a real. They have these real life.
Wait, they just start having sex with a blow up doll in public?
No, they'll just like bring them around.
Oh, actually,
like it's your girlfriend.
Oh, like it's your like this is my boo.
Yeah.
Like feeding her and shit, like took her out to lunch.
Like they'll be like at
that's a thing?
Restaurant, like chilling. Yeah. Yes.
Like dress the balloon
yes.
person
yes.
and everything. That's
no,
hilarious.
No, but it's like a
it's almost like a mannequin.
Yeah, she's got the mouth all open. He's like here, eat. Maybe an In-N-Out.
There's a movie on it too.
It's on that fetish in itself.
Fucking hilarious. It's with. Oh my God, what's his name? That he's one. A big actor, man, and it's the funniest fucking thing in the world.
All right, we're gonna look into it.
He really believes. That this doll is like real and like he's at his parents' house and he comes home with the doll and they like are like fuck but then they go with it because he's like kind of fucked up in the
yeah
head.
They're like just let him do his thing
yeah dude, it sounds like so weird
sounds like a My Strange Addiction
there's gonna be so many people googling this movie yeah, like after this interview like oh what is that
one of the funniest things I've ever seen in my life. Like, I can't take it serious. I just can't look at it.
No, it sounds hilarious. I'm definitely going to look that up when I get home.
Yeah.
That and balloon porn, which is like a whole nother world in itself.
I wish I would have started off doing balloon porn.
It sounds like soft porn.
But yeah, it's
like,
it's
I mean,
really
like,
mild.
I would have a hard
like,
time getting off
it.
On balloon porn myself, but I'm sure some dudes out there just, I mean, there's some crazy fetishes.
And
crazy
I mean, the fetishes. Feet, but like the foot fetish. Had I been more educated on the porn industry going in, I would have just done weird fetishes that are just like random
like,
shit.
Yeah. What are some of the weirdest fetishes you've ever heard of?
In this industry. I mean, there's one that's like, it's pretty common, and that's like the fetish for smell or like sweat, like certain people's like smells.
They like BO?
And yeah, like I've gotten that from like a couple
don't
different people.
Don't shower for a week and then you come on set ready to rock.
Yeah, well, he was like, I was talking about, because whenever I'm on set, like, and I'm doing a scene, for whatever reason, like halfway through it, I end up like sweating like a rapist because there's like a million lights on me and I'm just like an animal.
Yeah, those lights can get pretty hot too.
Yeah,
when you're on set.
Just like, ridiculous.
And I'm sure you're a little nervous too, you know? So yeah. It's like, okay, let's do it.
And you're not fucking like regular, like all lazy at home. Like you have
they probably
to,
turn
like,
the heat up too, especially if it's that kind of film.
Well, when you're filming, you can't have the AC on.
Oh, yeah, because you can hear the fans.
So you're just like in a hot ass room, just like dying. But we got in the conversation of sweat one day, and I remember a guy on set was telling me, he was like, yeah, that's one of my biggest fetishes is when girls are like sweaty and like you can smell their sweat. And I was like, what?
Like, are you serious?
I was like, okay.
I guess that's one wild fetish.
And then, I mean, there's the foot fetish, which, I mean, is pretty common.
Oh, my God. I remember being in high school, and these dudes, we went to a Bumbershoot concert up in Seattle. And, of course, it's like a bunch of dudes in one house, and we're all partying. And someone throws on the porno, and this chick's choking on a foot. And I'm like, holy shit. I'm like, this is real shit. And that's like what I found out about foot fetish. No, like, she was literally, and it became this big joke the whole week. And we called her like gargle throat or something. Like foot mouth. It was foot mouth.
Oh my God.
Dude wrote a rap about it the next day. It was hilarious.
Damn.
But have you ever done something like that?
Oh, yeah. I've stuffed a whole foot in my mouth.
A couple of foot?
Like one whole foot.
Oh, damn.
I couldn't get two, I don't think.
That's wild.
It's kind of, it's like the.
Do you have any special tricks?
Any special tricks
that you were like, yo, the Adria, this is like her move right here. No other girl can mimic this move right here.
Well, I mean, and I hate to sound like
or a specialty.
Literally every other basic bitch that's probably been a porn star on here, but like, I legitimately don't have like a gag reflex.
No shit.
Like, and it's become an issue sometimes because I've been really drunk at parties and I've been like over the toilet, like, please throw up, like, whole fist
like,
out
I
my
can't.
Throat. And
just I mean, my elbow is in my mouth.
Exactly. Holy and like, my shit. Girlfriend's like trying to like do it too, and I'm like, there's nothing happening.
We're talking about horror films now. I guess movie It's coming out, or it's out now, right?
It is, yes. Officially.
And you guys are going to go see that after this?
Yeah. IMAX.
We are.
Ooh, we're like in like the big legit theaters too.
Experience.
Here in Hollywood or what?
Universal.
Oh, that sounds even more legit than Hollywood.
It's going to be great.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be great.
So you guys horror film fans or?
Yeah, yes. I am. I'm a big fan of like good like psychological.
So you guys were obviously friends
thrillers.
Before you came on the show? Because I know that we have two separate guests. So you guys like hang out outside of here, right?
Yeah. Well, she's like lives homies. Like literally right down
is
the
street. Is she like your workout coach?
I wish I was that motivated.
She's like, no, she don't listen. She has that
she
look.
Doesn't want to yet.
Yes.
But you're kind of egging her on to do it,
we've
right?
We've been considering like possibly like moving in with each other, and I think that might be the final step.
Danny, where do you stay now? What part
me?
Of town you in?
Same.
Studio City?
It's like, I'm right not kidding, there. Like right down the
I
street.
I love it over there. It's nice. Like if I didn't live over here in like West Hollywood, that's like another area I would consider.
It's nice. I can like walk to the gas station.
Really? Why is that? Ready for something new? You've been there for what, 4 years?
Just makes me want to just
See,
I can't do the apartment complexes.
Oh, God.
I've considered it, but those like neighboring walls.
Apartment complex one day. Jesus Christ. That place is.
She's like, I'm about to give them the worst Yelp review right now.
I am going to. I swear to God.
Do you do Yelp reviews?
Only when I really feel like I should.
Yeah, right? I feel like
that's
what it is.
Been
like,
one
you
time.
Fucked up. You're getting the Yelp review
that's,
now, fam.
That's one time, and I probably for sure am going to have to do it. I'm going to have
She's
to.
She's like, I'm going
to
have to
I do
there.
It. I do it every now and then. I'll review some. You have to go, like, exceptional service, and I'm like, yo, that waitress was, like, so legit. Not only is she going to get a fat tip, but I'm going to write her a nice review, so maybe her manager will see it, and they'll get rewarded.
Yeah.
Or you really fucked up, and the place sucks completely, and I'm going to let you know, too, that way, too.
Yeah.
I remember going to a place one time, and it was like, you know when they charge you for a debit transaction, like, oh, it's a 35-cent fee or whatever. It was like $1.50 just to like to buy a sandwich. And I was like, man, that's kind of ridiculous. You know, then the lady was like rude and everything. So I was like, yeah, you're getting the Yelp review. I'm like, sandwiches are bomb, but the debit transaction's $1.50 for the $3 sandwich. And I was like, through the review.
I
guess
so
I feel
like
kind of a dick move.
Yelp you.
You're getting Yelped right
Yelp
now.
Yelp
yelping.
Like,
I'm yelping.
Well, I am yelping.
I feel like now they're getting like thirsty for the Yelp reviews.
They are.
Whenever I go to my nail salon, like afterwards, if I'm like,
You do the Yelp review for me?
Yeah, exactly.
you do the Yelp
exactly.
review? So nice.
Like, you want to take a picture? I'll take a picture right now. And I was like, no, it's fine. I'm not going to give you a Yelp review. I'm just going to tip you like a normal human
Can
being.
I just throw you a dub and call it good? I'm like, my battery's on 3%. Look, I can't really be doing all that right now.
Yeah. Like, I'm only going to take that effort if I'm upset about something.
Yeah.
They're talking about doing a Yelp review for people. Or like they could do like a like review a person. Like
now
you can actually like go
just,
on there.
It's just an episode of Black Mirror all over.
That's fucking lame.
What's Black Mirror?
What?
Fill me in. Adria, come on. Put me on game. This is the Kickback Show. Let's hear about it.
I
want to
be educated.
I'm like Black Mirror.
Well, I'm sure majority.
Do you even know about this, Danny? Okay, I guess we're all getting educated, fellas.
It's a new series on Netflix, and it's the premises of it is basically how technology is advancing really fast and how it's really good, but it also has like a lot of negative effects for our society. And there was an episode on it that was kind of based on that concept where you were able to rank people after every single time you had an interaction with them. And then your like person rating like was kind of like a credit score. So yeah. Like if you wanted to get into certain
a job or something,
yeah,
or apply for a house,
a certain
like,
apartment, they're like, oh, person, well, bro. Like, I don't know, like you're not that like
you're ranking in at a 3 out of 10 right now.
Yeah,
I don't know.
And they like track your social media and like all. It was crazy. It's a really good episode, but it's
kind of scary, but kind of real at the same time.
It kind of makes you think of like how invested we are.
Yeah, we definitely live in the matrix.
Yeah, in our phones and kind of just like what other people think of us online.
Right.
And that was kind of the whole thing around it. So it's a really, it's really good show. It's definitely like a psychological kind of thriller thing.
Okay.
It gets you kind of thinking like, oh shit, like
yeah.
We might be heading this way.
It's
like,
good. It's an eye opener though. You know, obviously you want to know about these kind of things.
Yeah.
Now you're going to start protecting that that personal credit score. Right. Like, hey, that's crazy.
But yeah, it's definitely worth taking a watch. And even if you're nice and stony, it's
Black Mirror, huh?
So good one.
And we were talking about watching It.
Yes.
That's, dude, I'm just that's so tonight. This, it's literally in.
And you guys, are you guys into horror films much or?
Yeah.
So that's yes. your thing? Scary stuff over like comedy or what?
I'm so into it.
I like it's scary. Like I like creepy. Good.
Do you have
scary
a favorite
movies,
horror film?
Though.
Either of you?
Mine was, we actually were just talking about it. Mine's actually The Shining. Because
that, oh, that's right.
That was the first movie, like, as a kid.
I'm sure that's a respectable,
that
like,
really
yo, that's a good.
Scared the shit out of me.
Yeah, that was kind of yeah. creepy. I don't think as a kid I even watched that all the way through. I'm like, yo, this kid's creepy. Like,
every,
the kid is creepy.
Yeah, and I think every kid's fear is, like, their parent Rob. Going crazy and, like, trying to kill them.
Yeah.
So, like.
Yeah.
My kid told me he was going to kill me today. He's I'm going to cut your skin and you're going to die. I was like, damn, bro. I was like, how about the Legos? Let's go back and play with the Legos. You know, this is a four-year-old. He's telling me this. I'm like, what are you watching on YouTube?
What?
Yeah, we're going to go see It later if you guys want to join us.
That's so funny.
No, we're not actually.
Just have him terrified of
but I feel like maybe I'm like, damn, I don't know where he's getting this from. Like, because yeah. I only have him on like PBS Kids and all this shit. Now all of a sudden he's telling me he's going to cut me and my skin off and
oh.
I'm going to die. I'm like, damn, bro, you need to chill out. School shooter.
School shooter.
Anyway, I hope he doesn't grow up to be like that. He's a good kid, though. He means well.
Yeah.
I just think he was having a moment because I took the cell phone.
Well, like,
away
from I feel
him.
Like all little boys have those, like, violent yeah. tendencies as, like, kids.
Oh, yeah, he
too.
Gets his ass whooped.
Yeah, because he's just like,
yeah.
There's just too much energy as a kid. Even when I was oh, a kid, yeah. I would say, like,
I would say some weird shit when yeah. I said some weird shit.
I remember when I was, like, 12, I would always make, like, really, this is terrible for me to say.
Yeah.
But I would always make really fucked up, like, dead baby jokes to my mom
oh,
all the
God.
Time.
Not those.
Because I knew they would just make her mad. Right. And that was the only reason I would do it. And, like, now looking back at this as an adult, I'm like, I'm a terrible child. Like,
yeah,
I feel
that's
so
harsh.
Bad for my parents.
I know. Adria, how does your mom feel about you being in the adult film industry now?
Well, she was absolutely mortified when I first told her.
Wait, so you told her she didn't find out the hard way?
No, I actually had to be upfront with her. Me and her
she's like, where are you getting all this bread from?
That was the thing.
Yeah, she's like Gucci purses, yeah. and this, and the Benz
and
now.
I was
and
still living at home in Michigan, so
okay.
like. There's just not that
flying
much money
out,
there.
Right?
Yeah, and I had already moved out of my parents' house, so I was
yeah,
just,
what age was that?
17.
Okay.
I left, and I graduated early, and I actually moved in with my friend, and I was working a lot, and so I was always kind of, like, on my own, like, independent, and then my mom just kind of started getting suspicious because I was gone for like mm-hmm. a week and like just making excuses like, oh, I'm really busy today. I can't see you.
Yeah.
Sorry.
She's sitting on the beach in the Bahamas butt naked like, come on.
I literally was
17 years
minutes,
old.
No, well, I was also 15 minutes down the street from her.
Right. So,
so
you really had to come up with excuses.
Yeah, like I was really like
so
dodging
her. I'm on my way over to your
right.
house. I'm not even close, mom. Don't even bother.
Yeah.
And I mean, I did work a lot at the time.
Sitting poolside in Beverly
before
Hills.
Before I started doing porn, I worked 40 hours a week, so she always understood that I was like busy.
Okay.
But
what was your job? What was your first job?
I originally was working at the mall. I worked at Brookstone.
Okay. From Brookstone to porn star.
I know.
Well played.
And then I also worked at a financial firm.
Okay.
A financial
That's
assistant.
Not as exciting as Brookstone.
I know. It's
not. Brookstone. Brookstone's got all the like the little gadgets and stuff, right?
I was like
the
that,
massage chairs.
Oh, yeah. Like I was that chick that stood out front, like flying yeah. the drone, like, hey, guys,
yeah,
come in and buy my shit.
Look at this thing. It moves. It's got a controller in it. Okay.
Yeah. And I would like
bucks.
Be doing flips with it and shit. So that's
I feel like a lot that stuff's overpriced.
It is.
I go in there, I'm like, man, it'd be like $300 for this little thing. Like, what does this do?
And it'll like, break so like, in like a day.
Yeah, I'm like, or it breaks in your hand at the store. I'm like, sorry, I don't know what happened here, you know? You're like, it's okay, just bye-bye now.
Yeah.
But
Danny, yeah. What was your first job?
Oh.
Ho?
No. I was trying to remember.
We talked about that. Ho cards. We don't have a ho card anymore.
No. My first job was me working at fucking Runza.
What's that?
It's this fast food place. It's so good.
In Nebraska?
Can't get anywhere else. Yeah, it's only in Nebraska, and it's fucking bomb. But
shout out to Runza. Do they still exist?
Yeah, dude. Okay. Oh my god, people like get them like shift like frozen.
Like in and out in LA, yeah, like runs out of Nebraska. People.
Yeah.
Like, are you familiar with this place?
I've never trekked into Nebraska.
What kind of establishment is it? Like a burger joint or?
It has like that, but like what they're known for is like these meat filled like pockets with like this amazing like dough bread. Like,
oh my god, you're making me hungry.
Like, oh my god, and you put cheese in it.
Oh god.
Like, oh my god, it's so good. So that was my first job when I was a cashier and
clocking dough.
Man, I was 14 and I did that. And then I just had jobs like ever since.
You guys seem like hard workers. Hustlers. Like you've always been on the grind.
Always. Hustling since 18.
You said 14. Why are you lying?
18, technically.
Oh, okay. Legally.
I left the house when I was 18. That's more difficult than me.
Well, since we're talking about Nebraska, I actually found the Nebraska Ned video.
I see
this. Okay, let me show you guys this real quick. Let's check this out. So this is Nebraska Ned. Came up with it a long time ago. And that's Nebraska Ned.
That's so funny.
So that was basically all I have as far as knowledge of Nebraska, which is something I invented myself.
Yeah.
But I had to share that since you said you were
from
Nebraska.
That's so funny. Man, whenever I see anybody like here that has a Nebraska's license plate, I'm like,
hey! You're like, family! Family! Yeah, we out here!
Funny.
I meet a lot of people from Michigan out here. I just feel like because it's
really Michigan's a big state too.
Yeah,
and it's just kind of shitty.
So everybody's like, "Fuck this, we're going to Cali."
Yeah,
and I feel like they also kind of have that like Eminem dream story. They're like, "Oh, maybe I could be like him." Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Palms are sweaty eating mom's spaghetti.
Exactly.
We already know
about
that.
You got one shot, one opportunity.
Right? Is that how you moved out here feeling like? Dun, 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 yeah. Dun, dun, dun.
Like I was in the airport, like hyping myself up with my hood up.
Here we go.
Yeah.
I like it.
No, I was actually terrified because I was really worried my parents were going to find out. So I came out very like, nobody can know who I am and no one knows my real name and I'm not even here.
So you just came out and started cranking out films, right?
Mm-hmm.
And from what I understand, Chatsworth, is that like the porn capital or something like that? People are telling me
it's just kind of like the valley, I think you would say.
Oh, the valley in general now?
It's like encompassing the valley.
Okay.
If you live,
Chatsworth is the headquarters?
If you live in an Avalon in the valley, there's a 95% chance there's a porn star who lives in your building.
Okay. An Avalon. Is that like an apartment company?
Yeah, and they have multiple communities. You
know, pass in the elevator,
the
like, girl, I swear I just saw you on Pornhub like 30 minutes ago. Now you're in the elevator with me? This is awkward.
There's this girl, and she, I haven't decided yet, but I think she is. I think she's a porn star. She lives in my building. And she's this blonde girl.
You guys keep giving me that side eye every time you pass. I'm like, I've seen you. I can tell by the way you walk.
She's always standing outside in the morning with a suitcase, which is usually like a telltale sign.
She's a
like,
stripper?
That's the wardrobe.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, where are you going?
See, I'm from Portland. It's like the strip club capita of the world. There's more strip clubs.
Oh, really?
Or capital. There's more strip clubs per capita in Portland. Like literally every other block has like a strip club on it.
I haven't danced in Portland or Oregon, so I wouldn't even.
Oh, so you used to dance or do you still dance?
I still dance. Yeah,
so you dance and film. See, You should probably check it out.
Yeah.
Money's probably not as good as Vegas. Obviously, a lot of girls go to Vegas and get that dough. But
actually, Vegas, the funny thing about Vegas is when you go as a feature dancer, it's a little bit different just because you're kind of like the main host of the club.
Okay.
And you only dance for 3 songs on stage. And then after, you have a meet and greet, but it's kind of in the back away from the club.
Uh-huh.
And in Vegas, there's millions of fucking girls. So, like,
everybody's trying to get it.
Yeah. The second you walk in, you're just being hounded. So,
fighting for dough.
The competition's a little bit higher. So, you don't really rake in as much as you do, like, with the smaller towns because they're like, oh, somebody big is coming. And, like, mm-hmm. No one ever big is here.
Right.
Like, Vegas has people there all the time. So yeah. I think it's just like.
Do you have any favorites in the industry, in the adult film industry?
As far as like working with?
They're just guys or girls like, oh, she's dope or he's the man. I can't wait to fuck him or whatever.
I have
it is.
2 porn crushes that okay. I haven't been able
guys
to work
girls?
With.
Guys or girls?
Girls.
Okay, so are you more into girls, huh?
I am in the industry.
Is that like, more? Is that more your like thing? It's like we can catch you on more girl on girl action videos. Is that what it is? Or
I think it's probably equal.
Okay.
It's just that like a lot of guys in the industry, like I just don't.
Yeah.
Like, they're just...
Been around the block one too many times.
Well, they're just a different breed.
Right.
Dude, I just think, like, dealing with somebody that, like, I don't know.
I feel like a lot of the girls all know each other for the most part. Like,
pretty much, yeah.
Because we had some other girls on the show, and we started dropping names. They're like, oh, we know her, and this and that. I was like, okay, damn. Everybody's, like, one big family out here.
I mean, guys, to me, and as terrible as it's going to sound, but when I show up to set, when I see a guy, I'm like, you're just a dick for this.
Yeah, he's a stud.
Yeah, like, I'm like, cool. Like,
it's like the bulldog that they just mate. It's like, get on in there and do the job, buddy.
And like, I mean, some of them are cool. I've been friends with a couple of them. But as far as like the girls, they're the ones that I usually get excited to work with.
Cool.
Just because like, I'm like, oh, if you're cool and I like fucking you, like, and you're dope, like, we can hang out and fuck and be friends. Like,
that's a win-win-win. 3 for the price of 1. Exactly. And I'm getting paid. What?
Yeah, like, it's really fun, so.
That's what's up. That's what's up.
There's 2 of them. One is, her name's Adria Fox.
Okay.
I've had a crush on since, like, the.
You're Adria.
I'm Adria, yeah.
When can we catch the Adria and Adria compilation?
I hope. Soon, because like I've had the biggest crush on her since like
nice.
I saw her.
Well, maybe we'll put that energy out there and you can get
it. I know. I've already been like hinting on my social media. I'm
okay.
Like, hey guys.
Damn, you fine girl. Let's do something.
And then another one is Keisha Gray.
Okay.
Because
I'm bad with names, but it's good to hear this stuff, you know, because I'm sure people out there are like, damn, Keisha Gray, she is fine.
Yeah, she is. And I think.
Do you know who she is?
Yeah.
Danny's like, yep, she's definitely fly.
Yeah, like she just has like something about her. It's like very like adorable and like cute. Mm-hmm. And like she's just kind of like a just like genuinely sweet girl from like what I've encountered with her.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, yeah, I definitely want you to sit on my face.
Do you have plans for after the film industry, the adult film industry? Or are you planning on just being riding it to the end till the wheels fall off?
I don't know. I think it kind of just depends on like how it goes. I'm a very like go with the flow.
Yeah, same
person.
Here. I actually have a tattoo that says go with the flow.
But I'd eventually like to go into like having some property, owning it, being able to rent it out to people, even if they were people in the industry.
Hey,
like,
investments.
I know it's a little difficult for people or young girls that are coming out to California, like they need spots or whatever to stay. And it's
not easy.
Yeah, they don't have credit. They don't have shit. Like they're just coming out here to work.
Come to mama's house. We got you.
Like
right here, cheap rent. We'll put you on a couple films. You know, everything's gonna be all right.
Exactly. And I'd also love to give a little friendly, advice as well. Because,
from your experience.
Yeah. I feel like it's important to educate girls that are coming into it just so that they know what they're getting.
Right. Because you had no idea.
No, I was like, fucking.
I got to give it to your boss for that. Because it takes
totally
someone with some cojones to really come out to LA and be like, no matter what industry you're in, really. I mean, even you too, Danny.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to just come out to LA and be like, here we go.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And
peace out, Nebraska, Michigan. We're doing Los Angeles.
Yeah. Exactly.
It's hard too. Mm-hmm.
It's a fight out here.
And there's a lot of people out here that are like, they're going to try to lead you in the wrong direction
because
it's going to benefit them or,
get
them ahead. And like,
everybody's in it for themselves,
interest.
Right?
Yeah. And so it's really easy to kind of get sucked into that, especially as a girl. And if you're pretty, and then God forbid you're naive too because you're just a sweetheart, like, you're going to get spit in and chewed out.
Hey. Sounds like a porn term.
I know.
So anyway, we were just puffing on the little vape pen here. You guys obviously smoke weed, right?
Yes, I do.
Sativa or indica? And what's your favorite?
I am an indica smoker.
Danny, you smoke?
Oh, yeah.
Indica or sativa? Yeah.
Both.
Really?
Yes.
I like sativas. I feel like indica. My buddy told me this one time we were on tour. I used to DJ for this dude named Riff Raff. And I was on tour with this dude. So
the porn industry is very familiar with
I'm sure Riff, you guys
right?
know good old Riff. You know his first name is Horst?
Horst?
Horst Simcoe is Riff Raff's real name. He's going to hate me for saying that, but we'll have him on the show in a few months here. We'll talk about it. Good people, though. But anyway, the videographer was on the tour bus with us, and he's like, I only smoke indica.
Mm-hmm.
And this is when he really informed me of like what the difference was. I was like, what's the difference? I hear indica, sativa, indica. He's like, indica is in the couch. He's like, you smoke indica, you're in the couch. And I was like, that makes so much sense.
Yeah, yeah.
So I was like, for me, I'm a very upbeat person. I like to drink coffee, smoke weed, and get shit done, you know? So it's like sativa does the job for me. I like to medicate, so I'm not so like fucking out there because my ADHD kicks in and I'm doing a million things at the same time.
Yeah.
But if I can like drink a little coffee and kind of bring it down, then I'm like, okay, now we're cruising through this shit.
Yeah.
Sativa does that for me.
I'm like the total opposite. So when I'm sober, I'm like a hamster, like on the wheel. I'm like, go, 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 go.
Yeah. Well, I'm technically the same way. That's why I smoke, is to bring it down a notch.
Yeah. So like
then
that's
the coffee
why
gives me that go back.
I like that indica because I feel like it's like that strong enough, like mellowed out. I would probably be a terrible person, like, if I didn't smoke weed.
Yeah.
Just as far as the fact that I just am like...
Ugh. It's a way of life out here. You know what's crazy? Because in some states, it's still illegal.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
And, like, there, people are catching cases for that shit.
Nebraska
like, Texas
is still illegal.
Mm-hmm. Damn.
Yeah. And
I'm about to send Nebraska Ned back there and shift some things around real quick.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's doing good. Nebraska Ned got like 150 views on YouTube. I'd say things are looking bright for this guy.
It's going up.
Throwback. It's probably been like 10 years. Who knows how long ago. But yeah, so I guess we're kind of blessed in the sense out here.
Oh, 100%.
I mean, it wasn't even legal or it's still not rec, but it feels like everywhere I go, they're like in the club and someone's blazing. I mean, you guys walked in chiefing up the vape pens and everything. Hey, no worries. I actually got you guys some stuff from Incognito, so I'm going to hook you guys up with different flavors and whatnot.
Yeah, it's very like... it's very like second nature out here.
It
I
is.
Think, when
I think there's also like there's kind of like a buzz in the city, and it kept people like so from like stressing out. I feel like the West Coast is a very laid back vibe, you know. And LA is so intense that like if it weren't for weed, I feel like people would just be going crazy. Yeah. You'd hear about 100%. More like crazy shit happening.
Yep, I totally agree.
Danny, you're so iced out. I can't. All this gold and over here, it keeps catching my eye. You just love gold, huh?
I do.
You got the cherry earrings and the gold chain, flossy.
I like.
I want to hear more about the fitness modeling.
Well,
do you do like swimsuit modeling as well, or is it just like the competition stuff you were talking about?
No. I've been doing more like fashion kind of shoots and stuff.
Okay.
Because I
any editorial stuff or?
No, not yet. I just started doing it because I, you know, just started doing all this stuff. So I just like am now working with like a lot of photographers who have been wanting to shoot me since.
Forever.
Well,
going back to the DMs, well, like, okay, I'll give this dude a chance.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thirsty fucker, I'll give you a photo shoot.
Yeah. So, like, now since I, like, switched over from what I used to do.
Now you can get some of that cool stuff.
Yeah. So now I'm, like, taking the time to do it. Now it's just been, like, beneficial because it's, like, now I'm, like, trying to, like, get it to the next level of, like, seriousness.
And what's that? What would you consider the next level of seriousness? Obviously, you're going
just
to nationals for this thing. That's huge.
What was that?
I said you're going to nationals for that for the competition.
Just,
that's huge.
But I mean, just like looking more professional and like doing everything the right way.
Got it.
Connecting, networking with people.
Yeah, you know, you have to like change your whole like kind of look.
Totally.
You know, to be able to fit into that whole thing and do it correctly for it to work. So, but I was just like, I just literally like started like last month. And then, like...
Wow, so you're fresh to the game. Then straight to nationals 1 month in?
Yeah.
Danny, congratulations. So, that's huge.
Thank you. I appreciate it. But it's just been, like...
Power to you. I mean, I feel like I see you're going to probably excel
this
right
girl,
through this.
If you follow her on...
I'm glad we had you on the show now.
Yeah.
1 month in, because then when we bring you back on the show, like a year from now or something, probably all kinds of shit you've probably done and toured the world,
man,
and you come back and tell us all about it.
That's, like, my whole goal, man. And, like, I just want to, like, help... Eventually, like, the whole goal later down the road is to, like do my own gym kind of thing.
Okay.
And just basically work on just women and appearance and, like, everything like that. And
Because if you watch her social media, it's like, it makes me feel like the most lazy piece of shit ever. Like, I'm literally,
so you're
like,
just getting it, huh? Working out on the daily or what?
It's wild. Like, she'll wake up and she'll be like, on to the
you
gym.
You eat pretty healthy too, I'm assuming?
Yeah.
I'm assuming you eat pretty healthy too, yeah?
Yeah, I have a strict diet this next 2 months. So, it's really hard with a diet. That is the hardest thing to do, is the eating part. Because I cannot have any salt or sugar basically for the last like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And it was just like my body like started changing in ways, like, you know, like girls.
It's like almost like rehab. Not rehab, but
you're depriving.
Yeah, you're like rebuilding your body.
Yeah, you're going through withdrawals and shit.
I would like bruise like really bad, and like the bruises would not go away because I didn't have enough iron. Like.
So you got to balance all that.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it just happens, and like a lot of the girls told me that it does happen. Like, you just don't, and you don't have like your certain monthly thing happen, and like all that kind of stuff, where like it's just like it changes your body drastically. And it's very stressful, especially like after, if you like go back to eating shitty and like not doing what you're doing, like you just kind of, your body goes into shock,
right?
So you just overdo the salt and sugar and shit like that.
You look very ethnically ambiguous. What's your nationality?
Oh, I'm a Korean, German, Irish, French, and English.
Wow. A little combo. Well, what's your nationality?
Oh, gosh. It's like so disappointing.
And, well, you know Michigan, so it's about that's what you get right there.
Like, well, because the thing is, I just did this whole 23andMe bullshit test where you spit in it, and then like you send it back.
Oh, yeah. My brother was talking about doing that. Like, see what you're like.
And it like says like where you are from all over the world.
Right.
And I'm like,
the results are?
Yeah, I'm like doing it. I'm all excited. And I was like, oh, maybe I'll be something cool. Because I always get that, like, oh, what are you? Like, are you?
This is going to be good. I can't wait till this comes back.
Da, 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 da. I get it back and it's like, nope, you're 100% European. I was like, are you fucking kidding me?
That's the polite way of saying you're white.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. I'm literally like, no, oh, so I'm just white.
Sorry, white girl.
I had like 3% Balkan in there, and I was like, okay.
Balkan?
That's like,
I've heard that before.
It's kind of like by the,
like something they would sell at Brookstone.
Italian peninsula and like Bosnia and like kind of that region. That's okay. Like the Balkan region.
So a little bit Italian, so, European.
So it's like I'm white.
You're European as hell.
I'm just like the whitest thing walking.
But you don't look that way, so I can see why someone, I mean, obviously you kind of have that brunette white girl look, but you can be mixed with something. I'm like, yeah, you got some Italian.
They always ask me with the jawline. They're like, are you
But
like-
Danny, I couldn't even tell. I obviously you kind of, I see the Korean, a little bit of some Asian in there, but you obviously mixed with something, so I had to ask. Yeah,
no, I definitely got the Asian persuasion in this right here.
Right? That's what's up.
Yes.
I see you got tats on your hands. You got more tattoos than that?
Yeah, I just got like a couple like on my fingers, and I got like a little one. Fuck, this is a little.
What is the one on? What is this with the numbers, the Roman numerals on the side?
Oh, that's my birthday.
Oh, okay.
Roman numerals. And then I got one that says smile on like my wrist.
Tight.
I just got, and.
You got any tattoos?
Stay weird and shit and.
Yeah.
Stay weird?
Yeah, it says stay weird.
Oh, that's... Oh, stay weird?
Stay weird, yeah.
That's what's up. See, Portland has this whole thing. It's like, keep Portland weird. And it's like literally like weirdo central. Yeah. People thrive to be weird.
It is. It definitely is.
I guess they got that phrase from Austin. I guess Austin's kind of weird too, but who knows. I fuck with weirdos, though. I like being weird myself.
Dude, people should be weird. Be
just be yourself, right?
Yeah. Of course, 100%.
That's the whole point of it.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to be wrapping up the show here soon. I want you guys to plug your Instagrams where people can find you and where maybe you can get some fitness inspiration from you and whatnot. Danny, where can they find you?
You can find me on Instagram at L5Fitness. So it's ELLE and then number 5 and then fitness. And then same thing on Twitter. And my email's on there, so you can check me out. And
Word. Adria, what about you?
You can find me on Twitter and on Instagram at AdriaRayXX and follow all my hoe activities and adventures.
Hey, hoe tendencies. Danny, when's your next nationals tournament? Where can we find you? See you at that.
Oh, okay. It's in November on the 17th and 18th. In Miami.
Okay. So, if Miami bounces back after this crazy storm.
I hope so, man. It might.
I saw the Weather Channel truck floating down the street. I was like, the Weather Channel, of all people, like driving through it. Like, come on, guys.
Maybe I shouldn't have booked that ticket.
Uh-oh.
Exactly.
How about you go watch it tonight and then reconsider a few things and we'll take it from there.
Shit. Exactly.
Exactly.
Right. What about you? You got any films coming out soon that we can check out? Big releases?
Not any big releases, but I am making a couple of appearances. I'll be in New York first week of November. I'll be dancing at Sapphire in New York, and I'll also be dancing there right around Thanksgiving, so it's a cool time to come out and meet me and see my tits live and in person.
Yeah, throw some 20s at that ass, right?
Exactly. Help me pay my rent.
That's right. We're trying to buy houses out here. These ladies aren't playing around.
No. Exactly.
I want to thank you girls for coming on the Kickback Show today.
Thank you.
It's your boy, the DJ TJ, live on TKB, Wednesdays at 7 p.m. It's Dash Radio.